Coalesce provides database developers with the ability to customize and manage nodes in their data pipeline by using custom node types, otherwise known as user-defined nodes or UDNs. When building data pipelines in Coalesce, it can be helpful to create a custom node type to solve for specific use cases or data modeling scenarios, such as streams, dynamic tables, and external tables. To create a custom node type, navigate to the build settings on the left sidebar of your workspace and select node types. In order to create a custom node type, you can either duplicate an existing node type and customize the pre-existing configurations and templates for your use case, or start from scratch by selecting New Node Type. Let's take a look at the stage node that we've just duplicated. There are three major elements associated with any node: the node definition, create template, and run template. Let's look at the node definition first. The node definition defines the UI elements and other specifications about how the node will be configured for end users to interact with. You'll be able to define things such as the insert strategy, materialization options, and custom columns associated with each node. You can view a list of UI elements available for node definition within the Coalesce documentation. To configure a node definition, you will use YAML to specify the configuration options you wish to include in your node. There are some general configuration options in the node definition of any custom node, such as the name and color of the node, but the majority of the configuration happens within the configuration items. The first thing that should be defined in the config items of a node definition is the group or group name where the specifications you are configuring will exist. For example, we can see in a stage node that the specifications of the node reside under the options group of the node. With a group defined, you can now specify all of the items you want to include within your custom node type. Let's look at a few of these in more detail. We can see that each item or element included has a type or display name associated with it: materialization selector, multi-source strategy, toggle button, and so on. Depending on the element, there may be additional specifications needed to fully configure a specific item. For example, within the materialization selector, there are additional attributes available to us to configure. First, we see that the default for the materialization type attribute is set to table, meaning the default behavior of this item will materialize as a table in Snowflake. Next, within our options attribute, we give two options for a user to configure the materialization type of the node, either a table or a view. Finally, we have defined the isRequired attribute as true, meaning that the materialization type is a required field in the UI of Coalesce. We can continue to add or remove additional configuration items to our node definition as seen fit for any use case, such as removing the option to provide users the ability to override their SQL. The node definition can also support custom system columns that are defined in a similar manner to config items, but are located within the system columns object of your node definition. The same is true for mapping columns, which are additional metadata columns that can be added to the mapping grid. You can view all of the node definition config options in the node config options section of the Coalesce documentation. Now that we've seen how to define our custom node type, let's take a look at the second element of our custom node type, the create template. Both the create and run template, which we'll look at shortly, use a combination of Jinja and SQL for configuration. Let's walk through what is happening in this template. The first thing we see is the template evaluating if there is an override for the standard create template script that we are currently viewing. If the override is enabled, Coalesce will use the create script provided by the user. Otherwise, it defaults to the rest of the script we are viewing here. Next, Coalesce checks on the node config item materialization type to determine the materialization of the node. On the left side of my screen, I currently have an existing stage node open, and I can scroll through to see exactly how this create template is going to interpret the configuration of this node. If the materialization of the node is a table, we can see that Coalesce will run a create or replace table statement for each node using this custom node type. We can see how Coalesce loops through the columns in each node, determining the data types, values, and any comments associated with each column. Finally, Coalesce looks for any description associated with the node. If the materialization type is not a table and is instead a view, Coalesce will skip the create or replace table statement above and skip to the create or replace view statement found here. Because a view is not actually storing data, you will notice that Coalesce is not determining the data type or column length of the columns in the node. Once Coalesce knows which materialization type it is processing, it will select the data from the source columns of the node, which we can again see on the left side of the screen what will be processed by this template. The create template will also look for any joins, and if found, will determine the insert strategy associated with processing multiple nodes. Once all of this metadata has been processed, Coalesce will run the DDL, or data definition language, templated here in the create template for every node using this custom node type. By selecting render, we can preview the SQL that Coalesce is generating through this template. After the create template has successfully executed the DDL for a node, we can move on to the final element of a custom node type, the run template. Unlike the create template, which is generating DDL, the run template is used to execute DML, or data manipulation language, to load data into an object in Snowflake. Stage nodes are typically used as intermediate nodes, allowing you to apply business logic and transformations to your data. Let's see how this run template allows us to accomplish that. In looking at the run template of a stage node in Coalesce, we can see that several things are happening. First, the template is looking to see if tests are enabled, and if so, what the run order of those tests is. The run template has the capability to run tests either before or after data is inserted into the table. We can look in the metadata from our node on the left side of the screen to see how the template will process this. Next, the template looks for the table materialization type. Because a view doesn't actually materialize data in Snowflake, we do not need to consider views in our logic for our run template, which focuses on the loading of data into a table. Coalesce will then determine the need to run any pre-SQL. Once tests and pre-SQL are handled, Coalesce will evaluate the truncation setting of the node, determining if the table needs to remove all rows and reload all the records. Next, the insert strategy is evaluated in the template and will follow a different path for either unions or inserts. In the metadata from the stage node on the left side of the screen, we can see the insert strategy is insert. Coalesce will then create an insert into statement for the columns in the target node. This is followed by the select statement, obtaining the data from the source node to load into the target node, evaluating for joins, and insert strategy along the way. Once complete, the run template will execute any post-SQL associated with the node. The template ends with the execution of any node and column level testing that was configured to run after the completion of the loading of data into a table. Again, we can select render to preview the SQL generated by this template. And with that, we've finished exploring the three major elements of a custom node type. Custom node types give you an immense level of flexibility and control over how you build your data pipelines. While we covered several examples of how you can configure a custom node type in this video, Coalesce does not constrain you to just these examples. You have the full flexibility and freedom to develop custom node types for any use case. To learn more about the configuration of custom node types, you can visit our documentation.